What if we dared to imagine a world without borders? What if we broke free from the confines of our comfort zones and embraced the power of collaboration? Today, we gather to celebrate the journey of a group of American students from Southern California who dared to dream, flying 6,000 miles to Wales, where they joined forces with a passionate and talented group of Welsh young people who shared their love for filmmaking and broadcast journalism. In a world where boundaries can separate us, they proved that when we unite, the possibilities are limitless. Together, they brought their unique perspectives, diverse talents, and incredible dedication to create something truly remarkable. They met deadlines with unwavering commitment, overcame setbacks with resilience, and embraced both adversity and success. As they journeyed together, they discovered the transformative power of friendship, forging bonds that will endure a lifetime. They shared laughter, support, and encouragement, reminding us that when we come together, we can achieve greatness. Today, as we celebrate their achievements, let us remember the potential that lies within collaboration. These students exemplify the creative future of film and television, breaking down barriers, pushing boundaries, and telling stories that resonate deep within us all. They remind us that the world becomes a richer place when we step beyond what is familiar and embrace the beauty of shared dreams. The 2023 Cardiff Content Creators Summer Showcase begins right now.
Hi, my name is Anastasia, and today we're in Cardiff, and we're going to ask people about their opinion on Welsh language.
Yeah, I definitely think people should learn to speak Welsh.
Dim siarad Cymraeg, which is, I don't speak Welsh, yeah. And well.
Fan Welsh y Twygis fel gen o fi trob yn Sabasilio Gwgwgwg.
I only really know, like, a saying, which is Wester Bamsa, but...
It's good to learn Welsh and keep up the language, because it's been a language that's been fought for and fought over for centuries.
As I've got older, I realised like how important it is and like what it actually means to people living in Wales to actually speak Welsh.
And it's hugely important for a country and people to know their own language.
But I mean, my children go to Welsh school, so I think it's great that they're learning it from young. It's part of their, you know, sort of culture.
You know, when I was in school, the Welsh language and Welsh lessons were always seen as a free lesson almost, where you could just do whatever you want.
You know, I think that it's great.
More people speaking Welsh.
Yeah, thank you so much.
Okay.
Inside Cardiff's Millennium Centre stands Natalie Hodgkins, a passionless woman who has brimmed
more than just coffee.
I wanted to kind of engage with young people in a different way. So I found a bit of an obsession for coffee around this time and decided to put both of them together, basically. So combine my love for coffee with my passion for working with young people as well, yeah.
Natalie owns Boston Brew, a coffee shop dedicated to provide opportunities for young people in the coffee industry.
So it's really about making sure that young people know it's a space for them and an industry that they can actually have a really great, meaningful career out of it if they so wish.
Natalie loves working to help her community.
We're able to connect with local people on the doorstep here in Bute Town and Grangetown, which is where I've grown up, so I'm very passionate about making sure that these opportunities reach young people on our doorstep first and foremost.
Natalie understands the importance of creating opportunities for her own children and the youth in her community.
But really, coffee's the medium that we use. It's all about building confidence and self-esteem amongst young people.
The impact of Boston Brew goes far beyond the coffee they serve.
So if we can have an impact on young people and boost their confidence over the time they spend with us, along with a bit of a caffeine kick as well, then yeah, that's a job worth it.
Through coffee in one hand and confidence in the other, Natalie is creating baristas and providing young people a path to success. Reporting for Cardiff Content Creators, this has been Zayden with Anna, Hilda and Danica.
The Cardiff Market refurbishment was announced earlier this summer with Wiz Breddon. Have you heard about the refurbishment at Cardiff Market?
Yeah, I have heard about it.
We're here today to ask local vendors and customers their thoughts.
This is happening next year, right?
Yeah.
I think it'll be a massive disruption because obviously it's the beating heart of Cardiff.
Have you heard about the refurbishment to Cardiff Market?
Yes, of course I have, yeah. We've put in for £10 million of lottery funding sponsored by the Welsh Government, and hopefully it'll come through in the next couple of weeks.
And so people that pay their taxes, for instance, and work very, very hard.
Well, apparently it's going to be closed for like 16 weeks.
Then what you've got to think of is, will the customers come back again?
Well, hopefully it'll improve the business. The only worry we've got is how long it's going to take and what they're going to do to relocate our stalls when the work is actually happening.
And I support small businesses, sure.
We don't know what they're going to do exactly. They have to keep the old heart of the market.
As the refurbishments get closer, the council decision to refurbish Cardiff Market will continue to affect the local vendors. Reporting for Cardiff Content Creators in Wales, I'm Paolo Bini.
It's £1, please. In this particular shop, we've been here 5 years.
Hayes New Kiosk, a local business in Cardiff City Centre, is owned by Jacqueline Crocker and her husband.
Oh, I decided to work here because I've done it for the last 30 years in different shops. So it's just something I've always done. My favourite part about working here is meeting all new different people and the social element of it as well. Yeah.
The location of the kiosk allows Jacqueline to socialise.
I think it's a good position because we're on the crossroads of the four different roads, and it's quite a busy position as well.
While the corner has increased businesses, the current location has not always been their home.
We were literally in that shop over there. We were in there for 16 years.
Since moving, Jacqueline feels the change has not been completely positive.
A bigger shop, so we could stock more. We moved from a bigger shop into our smaller shop. Now it's quite, trying to fit everything in is quite a challenge sometimes.
Although these challenges can be discouraging, Jacqueline does not let it affect her business.
People can see us better in this position than tucked away on the side.
The location on the corner brings in many customers, and one of the newspapers sells out more than the others.
Daily Mail. The Daily Mail always sells out first. Yeah, it's quite popular.
While change can be hard, Hayes New Kiosk will continue to look on the bright side. Reporting for Cardiff Content Creators, I'm Phoebe Gadd.
It's been 3 years since the Phantom Strider took his first steps in the criminal underworld. It's been years since I, Detective Aaron Patrick, was first assigned to investigate. But the case has gone cold, with footsteps being the only evidence left at the scenes. Justice seems unlikely. Will they ever be found? How long will the city live in terror? When will the chase end?
Where'd he go?
I can't believe I lost him! There he is!
This is Jodie Daniels. You can find her walking around Cardiff Castle, helping tourists and explaining its rich history.
I'm a tour guide, and then today I'll be checking tickets today here, speaking to you guys, and helping anybody out around the city.
Although he doesn't work a typical 9-to-5 office job, Jody loves the freedom that comes with his work.
Yeah, I'd much prefer not working in the office and being outside as much as I possibly can.
At the start of his career, Jody underestimated this line of work, but 10 years later, he finds himself interested in the challenges and knowledge that it brings.
It seemed like a relatively easy job, and then you start learning history as you're working and start taking tours around.
With his work, he also finds a new passion for history and telling this castle story.
To be honest, I wasn't 100% interested in the history I've learnt, but I've grown to love it.
This castle was built in the latter stages of the great William the Conqueror's reign. Cardiff Castle has a truly magnificent history of violence, scandal and wealth. Over 2,000 years later, Jody gets to tell the story of this truly iconic Welsh landmark. Reporting for the Cardiff content creators, with photojournalists Juliana, Fionn, Nina and Lena, this has been Fraser Blair.
Just keep smiling. Smile, smile away.
That's purgatory. It doesn't mean to say you're going to go to hell. It just means you've had a bad patch.
Jill, a fortune teller in the heart of Cardiff Market, has found a way to help the people in her community, even when they don't believe in her.
Usually when they come in here, they are a bit sceptic about it. But when they go out, they usually feel really good, because they've been explained to why this is happening in their life and how to deal with it.
With a job that lets her connect with so many people, Jill finds that the burden of their problems can weigh her down.
Because by the end of some days, your head is so full of other people's problems, it's hard to get rid of them.
Jill believes that her gift was generational and passed down from her grandmother, who predicted a tragic event in her life.
I think my gift comes from my grandmother. In my early marriage, I lost a child, and the first child I had was a little girl that lived a week, and my grandmother said to my mother, she will never touch that child, and I never did.
Despite the burden she carries through her life, she understands the difference she makes in her community.
And I think to myself, well, if I wasn't here, who are they going to talk to? Or who are they going to ask good advice?
From the start of her career, Jill knew that this was her calling in life.
And that was when my wings were opened. You know, I could do a lot more when I had access to people.
Jill has one main goal for herself every day.
If I helped one person in the day, then I've done my job.
With some of Jill's final words of advice.
This is my belief, not yours or anybody's, to judge me. I am who I am.
This has been Fionn, with videographers Lena, Nina and Fraser reporting.
I'll even bring my mother's mother here.
Are you okay?
Kid got a titfer for every occasion. I got your pre-owned denim, pies from Levi's.
My name's Stuart Talbot.
Obviously, you look around and you can see we sell a lot of hats.
The business is Hats Emporium, which is predominantly a men's outfitters or haberdashers, which will consist of vintage goods and also new goods, and also items that my son designs and other Welsh designers as well. We have all types of people in the store, to be honest with you, so all ages, all genders even.
Stuart likes to make Hats Emporium open to all customers, and he treats every customer to satisfactory service.
We aim to give the best, so I think that's what we want to do, is probably improve on what we do if we can, and make us more, and keep the customers we've got as happy as they have been up to now.
Yeah, it's a very nice shop. I'm a customer for ages. I come here every 2-3 weeks to buy something. It's a very nice stuff he's selling here.
Not everything in Stuart's life was smooth sailing, and Hats Emporium was built off of one of these bumps in the road.
What I did, I mean, I looked after my mum with dementia, and my son came home from uni one day, and we needed a way of staying home and looking after her, but also obviously securing money for ourselves. So we decided that we would work together in a joint venture, and that's how the shop came about. So really, basically, it was born of circumstance, but has become a real good friend to me and my son, and we enjoy every day we're working here.
Stuart's mother passing certainly made things more difficult, but keeping the Emporium alive, knowing she'd been part of its conception, keeps him going.
Immortality lives in the people we leave behind. So the more people that remember us, the longer we'll live. So if your mum goes and you tell your grandkids and your grandkids tells their kids, it goes on forever. So what keeps me going is I love the job. I love the people I see every single day. I work in a great environment. I have fantastic people around me. And the thought of her knowing that I've done all right. You know, we're surviving, I'm paying my bills, we're all living. She has exactly what she wanted and we're getting exactly what we want. So keeps me going at the thought that she would be proud of me, I think.
Stuart has persevered through many challenges, yet his business continues to thrive. For Cardiff Content Creators, my name is Emil Lefrachi.
My name is Heriberto de la Cruz Diaz. People call me Eric. You can call me Eric Diaz, easy. And I got a few businesses in Cardiff. My dad was caught in my head, tried to save some money. I was looking like at a mission, one of those dogs. And one day I said to him, Dad, can I do my haircut, please? And he was so angry with me, he called me ungrateful. He said, you have to do your own haircut now, or don't cut it no more. I was like, hallelujah, thanks God. At the beginning, my dream it was to be one of those barber people waiting for them. And they got like lots of clients and people know them. And then one day I closed my eyes, opened my eyes, and I was this barber. You know, but in between this close and open, it was a long story, a long journey, a lot of sacrifice. Because when this happened, one of my friends who owned the barbershop in the neighborhood, he said to me, come on to a barbershop, I want to show you how to be a barber. You know, so they are accepting, and they, I was helping, sweeping the floor, and I becoming a barber there. He teaching me. Sorry, I have fever. Sorry, I need some tissue. For the barbers. And I don't think like they're working for me. We're working together. Because on top of everything, they made their money and this is their business at some point. Uh-huh. If in life you want to do anything, but you what you achieve is the money you want to make. You are in the wrong place. You know, you need to do it for fun, because you love it. Because what can come out of this. And there, the money were coming by themselves.
Russia came to our country, decided they can destroy everything that we have. Destroy, I will say, not destroy just homes, not just kill people, destroy dreams.
So yeah, I'm a refugee and we are protesting, if you can see, and we are from Ukraine. We are protesting like every Saturday just to, you know, talk about that. Look, we are here, we are still here, and the war is not over.
Daniel and his fellow Ukrainian refugees peacefully protest in the Cardiff City Center every Saturday. They protest to keep the fight for Ukraine alive and to help Cardiff locals feel sympathy for those in Ukraine.
Yeah, I feel sorry for the kids who stay in Ukraine right now because there's the war, many people are killed.
For me, it's like really important to have some you know, effort, that I'm doing something, to stop this war.
Protesting in public often leads to opposing points of view.
Nothing more than just, you know, screaming on us.
But Daniel finds a way to stay focused on what matters to him.
For me, it's like I understand that they have their opinion, and it's peaceful protest. We're just standing here and saying our thoughts.
Even though they're trying to raise funds for local Ukrainian hospital support, to them, general awareness is just as valuable.
Even if you don't donate, we are completely okay with that. Our main goal is to people to know that this is happening. This is still happening.
Daniel's protest every Saturday have one main idea: keep the fight for Ukraine alive. Reporting in Cardiff, Wales, with photojournalists Landon Miller, Faye Glenn, Sierra Fessler, and Michael Basista, my name is Race Gruski.
Hi, my name is Morgan, and my life is kind of crazy.
Oh my gosh.
For example.
Oh my gosh, where am I?
Today, I was randomly teleported to a medieval castle because I answered a question on my phone. So weird. Anyway, here's the story. Boom, flashback. This morning, I was strolling down to my local Starbucks to have my favorite coffee, an Americano. And suddenly, there was a strange notification on my phone. I was curious, so I clicked it, and this is how I ended up here. Not only that, I think someone is approaching me. Roadmen!
Oi, oi, ti, beth ti'n gwneud yma?
What?
I'm dod o Lloegr. Caele!
And they're Welsh. They don't seem to like English very well.
Hello Cardiff, my name is Rhys Davis and we're here outside the Principality Stadium to ask people questions about the upcoming Wales vs England rugby match. So let's get to it. I'm Rhys Davis reporting for Cardiff Content Creators. So who do you think is going to win in the upcoming Wales vs England rugby match?
My heart says Wales, my head says England. The only thing is, if we can get out like unusually fast of the blocks, we should be able to do it.
So who do you think is going to win the upcoming Wales vs England rugby match and why?
Well, it might be unpopular on the streets of Cardiff, but we're going to say England because that's where we're from.
Well, actually, there's been a lot of changes, hasn't there? So I think it's probably going to be fairly tight. Maybe England to win by sort of one score, one try.
So what do you think the score's going to be in the upcoming Wales versus England match and why?
I think Wales will edge this one just about. I think we're going to be fifth after the training in Turkey and in Switzerland. So I think the score, probably Wales to win by about 12-15 points.
So who do you think is going to win in the upcoming Wales versus England rugby match?
Oh, definitely England. I think being an Englishman, I've got to say England. So,
what do you think the score is going to be?
I'll go 28-21 to England. So a tight affair, but one try in it, I think.
Very good. Thank you.
Well, we've just lost Adam and Jones and a lot of other good players who was referred to retirement. So I think it might go in England's way.
So who do you think is going to win in the Wales versus England rugby match?
Well, Wales, of course. Absolutely.
What do you think the score is going to be?
55-3.
Good answer. Thank you.
You're welcome.
So it sounds like it's going to be a close game then. Me personally, I'll be supporting Wales, but we'll have to wait and see on Saturday. I'm Rhys Davis reporting for Cardiff Content Creators, and we'll see you next time.
Here in Cardiff City lies the historical site of Cardiff Castle. Now an infamous tourist destination. The rich history of this castle has grown quite famous. A little less famous, the Hall of Names.
I am one of the chief assistants here in the Hall of Names, which is referring to heraldry and also the research of family history.
Located in a small shed in the centre of the castle, the Hall of Names doesn't quite have the history of the castle, but it's already showing signs of immense popularity.
This is a new venture for this castle, this particular Hall of Names. And it's been here for, over 2 years now. and we're doing well, and we hope to have more people interested in their research, and they do. They want to know a bit more about their background and what have you.
Since Thurn's been built in 55 AD, the Cardiff Castle has lived out the years witnessing countless historical events.
It is one of the oldest sites in Wales because it's of Roman origin. So we have 2,000 years of history, and each part of that history has been played out on this site.
And the castle's strong ties with the Cardiff community dates back to the 1900s.
Because in 1947, this castle was given officially and legally to the people of the city as a gift. So it's the only castle in Wales that actually belongs to people outright.
And with this gift, the Cardiff Castle remains an icon, growing in popularity with no sign of slowing down. For Cardiff content creators, with photojournalist Lucia Lewis and Rhys Davis, I'm Michael Sarsing, reporting.
And the cost of food, the cost of everything. The governments could do something about everything, but they don't. The people in government don't live the same life as us. They're not worried about our problems, don't worry about that.
Armed with their artistic talents, two performers here in the Cardiff City Centre are fighting against the cost of living crisis while pursuing their passion, making ends meet and putting a smile on people's faces.
To keep people happy. Too many miserable people and miserable things happening in this world, isn't there?
There are more challenges for street performers in the modern day and era.
I think it's good that people are out and playing music and stuff. Sometimes it can be a bit frustrating if you wake up a bit late and you don't get the best spot.
In modern times, buskers are forced to compete against each other as well with society.
It's challenging, but I think it's challenging for everyone right now. I think the cost of living is just constantly rising beyond the point of the means that we have.
In the future, Sean and other buskers hope that
the cost of living comes down.
Even though their passion for performing lasts a lifetime, the true value would be passed on to the Cardiff community.
I've always loved playing music, but I think also it brightens people's days up.
As the cost of living increases, Cardiff buskers will preserve for the happiness of the community. Reporting in Cardiff, Wales, I'm Noah Neal.
People come into the shop and they are taken back to a certain place and time where they were quite happy, maybe when they were younger.
Spiro Ferrucci.
This is like a dream job for me in a sense.
Works at his own retro, comic and action figure store here in Cardiff.
But it's hard work as well.
The nature of his store allows customers to be comfortable with themselves and with Spiro.
Sometimes I feel like a therapist, because a lot of them talk about the past and they want to, you know, get things off their chest, I don't know. So it's great that people can come in and share things like that.
Spiro's most important message to newcomers into this hobby.
It's the hunt that you enjoy as much as anything. It's an expensive hobby, I'll tell you that for nothing. But if you enjoy it, you won't look back.
Trust your instincts, follow your gut, go out and start your collection. Reporting Cardiff, Wales, my name is Finlay Owen.
Albert Einstein once said, "The distinction between the past, present and future is only a stubbornly persistent illusion."
All he does is spread lies.
People think of time travel as fiction, but mathematically, it is possible. Don't worry. I'll show you. I'll protect it with my life.
It's just getting strange. I need help. I don't know what to do.
All he does is spread lies.
It feels like I'm stuck. I've been living the same day over and over again.
With the recent talk of Scottish independence, Welsh independence has also come into question, and there has been much debate about it.
A negative for Welsh independence. I prefer a unified country.
are more pro-independence, or at least I'd say that there needs to be massive reform and changes within the UK government system.
I think we're best to stay as we are just now.
Welsh independence has really helped us to get investment in Wales compared to within a kind of UK government.
According to a poll done by Redfield and Wilson Strategies in 2023, only 32% of people have voted for Welsh independence, and the rest were either undecided or voted against Welsh independence.
It's all right to want independence, at what cost? It all needs to be rationalised and looked at.
Everyone's entitled to their own opinion. Everyone can weigh up the pros and cons of the argument and have a look towards it.
No, I think I'm comfortable with the one we've got at the moment.
I think we're best to stay as we are just now.
In the year 1277, Wales was invaded by the Normans. The castle we are in today symbolises Welsh culture and history. Some of the Welsh want this rich history to stand alone and want their independence. Reporting for Cardiff Content Creators from Cardiff Castle, I am Zach Ahmed alongside Betty Seward.
When I was learning to make music, I didn't have the YouTube videos. You had to figure it out. And I think because of that then, it was a real challenge to try and figure things. And I just fell in love with it, you know.
Meet Kyle, whose love of music has led him to want to help others in the community achieve their music dreams at Sound Progression, a Cardiff non-profit that mentors and provides opportunities for young people.
People that come in with a dream and ambition to develop their musical skills, and they might be artists, they might be producers. It's a whole variety of different musical paths that they might want to take. So I'm here to support that and to develop their skills.
Now meet Leighton Jones, who works closely with Kyle to make sure that the community that comes to Sound Progression feel successful with their music.
I love creating. I love teaching as well. I love it when, you know, people can actually do something themselves and you believe into it then.
But Leighton's passion developed during an experience most will never have to live through.
It's a strange one. So when I was 11 years old, I had a bone marrow transplant. And in those days, there was no Xboxes, nothing like that. And I had 2 years off school. So I picked up a guitar and started teaching myself.
Despite being self-taught, both musicians have found fame via their love of music.
Right up by the Heights and all that, and it was like a load of like Dominicans were driving past. They were blasting like some of the Latin tracks, like I heard my tag on it. I was like, oh my lord.
I've toured around the world, supported Eric Clapton, Bob Dylan, The Who, Alanis Morissette.
But neither lets their significant successes get to their head, instead focusing on working together to help people in their community experience their musical dreams.
So we take different sessions. So Kyle will take one session, I'll take another session. And sometimes we come together. It depends on different styles, like, you know.
The two work together to reach the community with the same goal of helping others.
I like the faces when they're actually doing things and they're creating things. It's an amazing experience.
When I get certain artists come through and the results are amazing, that's the best part of the job. And you see people leave with a massive smile on their face and going, wow, we actually made that here, you know?
Together, Kyle and Leighton's passions keep music dreams alive in their community.
Oh, do you believe in love?
Reporting for Cardiff Content Creators from Sound Progression Studios, I am Zach Ahmed alongside Betty Seward.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Good morning, everyone. Welcome to the morning news, where you get your news for the morning.
Breaking news. Banksy has put his new artwork on this new wall, and now they're going to take down the school and sell it for like $1 billion for some reason. No one knows why they're so expensive, but yeah, they are. This is what rich people want to do with their money, so, you know, let them do it.
Tune in to the news at 6 p.m. to see the latest movie trailers and the success of this project.
How did I get here? How? What is that? Maybe I can find a way off if I can find a way to the bridge.
My kids need to eat beans. My kids need to eat food. I don't have a house. I'm homeless now. I'm baseless. I don't have a bed. I have my dog. I have three dogs as well. I need to feed my dogs.
Camp has changed me by teaching me that there's going to be loads of opportunities in life and you just have to take them, and it's taught me to just have a go at everything, and just it's overall made me more confident.
I've like learned every single thing I've never learned about photography, so yeah, I've even had a wonderful adventure.
Because I feel like I've seen this new side of me that I've never really like been in touch with, like the side that really likes content creation, likes producing media.
Like when we first got here, I was quite nervous because it's something I haven't done before and I'm not like experienced with this. But then like as the days went on, I've got new confidence with this.
My camp experience overall was great, and I think I've got a new experience with the Americans as well. And since the Americans, they did it professionally, like in their school, like every day, the group got some insight as we were new to this.
So at the start of the camp, I was very nervous, and everyone here has made my confidence go right up. And when I interviewed someone, it just got my confidence more up.
It was really good. I learned about new AI, and I learned about a lot of things in the camera, and I know how to edit now, and I know how to use a green screen now.
I'm more confident now with working in groups with new people.
I've really enjoyed it, like particularly the videttes inside and filming and like sort of meeting new people and developing friendships throughout that.
Camp has changed me by making me more open and confident to this kinds of things and thinking about doing it in the future.
I came here from Ukraine last year, and I used to be really unconfident. I couldn't speak at all. Yeah, so this camp helped me to build my confidence, just to start talking with people. So yeah.
You get to do a lot in regards to filming and like editing and being in front of the camera.
Camp has changed me by learning how to go use cameras, experience how to edit.
It makes me feel more like I want to get into doing YouTube videos. And now that I know how to edit properly, I feel like I can do that now.
It's been good. I've had lots of fun. And it's been nice working with everyone else that has, yeah.
I'd say my camp experience has been pretty positive. You know, we've done a lot of different things. We've done the editing here at the college, and we've done a lot of filming in and around Cardiff. I enjoyed Tuesday when I got to do both sides. I got to do behind the camera and also in front of the camera.
My camp experience was really good. I learned numerous new skills, and I really enjoyed myself throughout this camp. I found it useful to know how to do interviews, how to do editing, the AI and the green screen was very interesting.
The camp's changed me by showing me that I can make stuff by myself. I don't need a big expensive camera or a big setup. I can even make something with my phone camera and software on the computer. It's really opened my eyes to that.
I think like meeting everybody and like
yeah, like talking to everyone and like making like new friends.
You work, but like you don't even realize you're working because like you're having like so much fun at the same time.
I'm more like so socially active and I could talk to people more normally than I used to.
I've really enjoyed it. It's been a lot of fun. I've learned stuff that if I didn't do this camp, I would never have been able to learn. Using a camera, learning what type of interviews you can do, and how to be in front of the camera, go up to people, and it's been really fun.
Probably a roller coaster of like emotions. Cause like it had ups, it had downs, it had everything in between. Really fun overall though.
It's been really incredible. It's been amazing seeing people not only grow in their digital skills, which is what we're here for, and their broadcasting skills, but also improving in their self-confidence and self-belief and their engagement. You know, I've had experience in this thing before, so my confidence still grown, but not as much. Whereas seeing the younger people come in and going from refusing to get involved at all to, you know, willingly engaging and feeling more confident in it has been really great.